Hello children, now continue the lesson, chapter 11. Today's topic is the Vedicas and social condition of this time. The basic unit of the society was the family. The eldest male member was the head of the joint family. He was known as Grihapati. Women were held in a great respect. They were educated. Women like Apla and Ghosha even compose hymns. The participation of wife was essential in all religious ceremonies. The social ills like Sati Pratha and child marriage were unknown to the early Vedic period, but they gained importance in the later Vedic period as the status of women declined. अब बोल रहे हैं कि शुरुआत में जब अर्ली वैदिक पीरियड के समय जो महिला थी उसको सर्वोच्च स्थान प्राप्त था, किसी भी संस्कार के समय उनका उपस्थित होना या उनकी उन्हीं के द्वारा ये इस चीज़ की शुरुआत की जाती थी, और उस समय सामाजिक कुरीतियाँ भी नहीं थी, चाइल्ड मैरिज, सती प्रथा, इसका भी चलन नहीं था। लेकिन लेटर वैदिक पीरियड आते आते ये सारी कुरीतियाँ शुरू हो गई थी और महिलाओं की जो स्थिति थी वो गिरने शुरू हो गई थी, स्थिति खराब होने शुरू हो गई थी, मैं समाज में बहुत सारी कुरीतियाँ व्याप्त होने शुरू हो गई थी। द सोसाइटी वॉज डिवाइडेड इंटू फोर वर्ल्ड कास्ट, नेमली ब्राह्मण, क्षत्रिय, वैश्य एंड शूद्र। ब्राह्मण लुक आफ्टर द रिलीजियस मैटर एंड क्षत्रिय प्रोटेक्ट द पीपल फ्रॉम इंटरनल एंड एक्सटर्नल हार्म्स। The Vaishya were the cultivators and craftsmen. The Shudra were the laborers who served the above three classes. Okay, varn system start ho gaya tha. The people of different varn had the freedom to intermingle, marry, or change their occupation. But in the later Vedic period, the varn system became hereditary and very rigid. No one could change the occupation of the world, but there were many areas like northeast where social and economic difference were not very sharp. Even the influence of the priest was limited. The Upanishad divide man life into four ashrams of 25 year each. A man had to spend the first 25 year of his life in a gurukul, where he learned the art of life and religion. This stage was called Brahmacharya Ashram. The second stage of 25 years was called Grihastha Ashram, when a man worked hard, got married and raised a family. During the third stage, that is Vanaprastha Ashram, he retired to the forest to meditate. In the last days, which is called Sannyas Ashram, he lived a life of complete detachment and spent his time in preaching. And occupation of that period, agriculture was the main occupation of the people. They used plough, which were pulled by oxen. During this period, people irrigate their field with water from the wells, canals and lakes. They grew wheat, barley, rice, bean, etc. and domesticated animal like cow, bull, sheep, goat and dogs. The Aryan was also introduced horse in India, which were brought from Central Asia. The discovery of iron had provided strong tools like plug, scale, saw, spear, axe, saw, nail and tongs, which helped in a variety of other crafts like pottery, weaving, carpentry, jewelry making, etc. The Aryan were expert trade was mainly carried on land. They used barter system. The cow was used as a standard of values. Yani cow jo gaay thi wo bhi us samay standard value ka kaam karti thi. Iske paas jitni adhik gaay hoti thi उसको उसके समाज में उसको उतना धनवान माना जाता था। रिलीजन्स, Earlier, Aryan worshipped many gods representing the force of nature. Indra was worshipped as the god of thunder. Vayu, the god of wind. Prithvi, the god of earth. Agni, the god of fire. And Surya, the sun god. Milk, ghee, grain, and flesh were offered as a part of the of sacrifice at yajns. The earlier Aryan did not build temple. In the later Vedic period, the yajns become very expensive, and the nature gods were replaced by new gods: Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva, Rama, and Krishna. Okay. The later Vedic period saw the birth of Brahmanism and Hinduism. मतलब लेटर वेदिक पीरियड आते आते ब्राह्मणिज्म और हिंदुज्म का शुरुआत हो गई थी. डू यू नो द लॉ कोड ऑफ मनु, मनुस्मृति और मानव धर्म शास्त्र वॉज प्रिपेयर बाय मनु. इट इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट लॉ बुक फॉर द हिंदू एंड अचीवमेंट. द वैदिक लिटरेचर थ्रू लाइट ऑन द अचीवमेंट ऑफ आर्यंस इन द फील्ड ऑफ साइंस. The Aryans knew the use of iron. They use it for making strong tools and weapons. The axe helps in clearing jungle and spreading agriculture. Craftsmen like carpenter, blacksmith, tanner were able to develop their craft with better tools. Iron weapons like spear, sword, and shield help in conquering new territories. Mathematics was known as Ganita. It include arithmetic, geometry, and algebra. The Vedic people had the knowledge of zero, which helped them to calculate large number. They also knew the decimal system, cube, cube root, square root, under root, and etc. Astronomy was the favorite subject of Aryans. The study of the movement of heavenly bodies. They knew about the movement of the earth on its own axis around the sun and the movement of the moon around the earth. The Aryan could foretell solar and lunar eclipse. The Vedic literature proved that the Vedic civilization was quite advanced. The people led a happy life, happy and simple life. Their clothes were made of cotton, wool, silk, and animal skins. They wore ornaments. They used madhu, honey, and took Surya and Somaras. They played many musical instruments like flute, drums, and harps. They were also fond of chariot racing, dancing, etc. Now, thank you, children.